probably get me in trouble, but I said to some of my colleagues recently, so I know that it's an issue, but it seems like every single day on television I'm talking about race, and it's because of the news cycle, it's in the news, but sometimes I get so tired of talking about it, I want to just go, this is over, can we move on?
And if you talk about it, it exists.
Right.
Yeah. It's not like it exists and we refuse to talk about it, but making it a bigger issue than it needs to be is the problem we have.
Black History Month, you find?
Ridiculous.
Why?
You're going to relegate my history to a month?
Oh, come on.
What do you do with yours? Which month is White History Month?
Well,
come on, tell me.
I'm Jewish.
Okay, which month is Jewish History Month?
There isn't one.
Oh, why not?
Yeah.
Do you want one?
No.
All right, I don't either. I don't want a Black History Month. Black history is American history.
How are we going to get rid of racism on?
Stop talking about it. I'm going to stop calling you a white man.
Yeah.
And I'm going to ask you to stop calling me a black man. I know you as Mike Wallace. You know me as Morgan Freeman.
All right, racism. I ain't hooked up in all that racism shit. My motto is life is just be happy with motherfuckers. I ain't into all that racism shit. Racism ain't as bad as it used to be anyway, man. I mean, it's fucked up, but they don't call niggas no more and shit. White people don't say it, especially when there's niggas around, so I guess I wouldn't know. Walked up looking for racism, but my friends always told me, you better not go to Texas. They'll fuck you up. And when my modern day brother here, that shit, they be like this, what? They ain't fucking nobody up. Brothers act like they couldn't have been slaves back 200 years ago. It ain't like them motherfuckers like that shit. I wish I was a slave. I would fuck somebody up. Shit, tell me to bail some motherfucking cotton. I would have been on the street and shit. You would have came up and said, hey, yo, nigga, bail this cotton. Oh, said, suck my dick, master. I got off the motherfucking plane, walked up my bag, all my black shit on, black leather, big ass medallion and shit on like this. Little white dude walked up and said, this your bag? I said, yeah, it's my fucking bag. Why, motherfucker? A black man can't have a suitcase?
This dude was like, what the fuck's wrong with this guy?
Time now you're doing colleges as well. That's probably something you did a lot more coming up. Have colleges changed?
Yeah, college kids now are so politically correct. I mean, to the point where, well, I'll give you an example. We had interns at the show, college interns. And like the last year of the show, when the interns come in and said, Mr. Leno, I'm getting lunch. What do you want? I said, I don't know. Where are you going? He said, we're getting Mexican. I said, I don't really like Mexican. He goes, whoa. That's kind of racist. No, it's not racist. No, being anti-guacamole is not racist, right. Okay? You have no idea what racism is. That's not racist, you idiot. You moron. Talking about, like, the food. My grandfather, who was Italian,
yeah,
he only ate Italian food.
Gotcha.
And it was always amazing to him that people would eat out of their ethnic groups. Like, he would go, look at that. Chinese guy with a hot dog. Look at that. Black guy with a bagel. A black guy with a bagel. A Korean guy with a pizza. What, look at that. Like a grandpa. It's not that big a deal. Really, it's not that big a deal.
And of course, you got worlds of shit. And I just feel like we're living in this country now where no one can make a joke. No one can have any nuance to what they say. We are just constantly hounded by the politically correct assholes out there who want to turn this country into a place that I don't want to live in. When I read those things that you did, you went to Katrina, you went to Pakistan, you went to Haiti, you actually are somebody who does something. I think most of these people on the internet, they've never done anything good in their life, and they want to feel like they're the good people.
Yeah.
And the way they feel like they're the good people is they find somebody who's the bad people. I'm a good person. I got rid of Donald Sterling. What a great victory.
I'm not a feminist. I hail men. I love men. I celebrate American male culture and beer and bars and muscle cars.
What about the argument going on in Hollywood at the moment that not enough black actors, in fact none, have been nominated for this year's Oscars?
Yeah, but there's loads of black actors. There's loads of black actors. And I think in the end, you know, you can't vote for an actor because he's black. And you can't just say, oh, well, I'm going to vote for him. He's not very good, but he's black. I'll vote for him. I mean, you've got to give a good performance. And just what a great thing about it is you don't have to go. Yeah. That's, you go, oh, God. I mean, especially the Oscar, you know, 24 hours on an airplane, I'm going to sit there clapping Leonardo DiCaprio.
So again, your message really to those non-white actors is be patient.
Of course it will come. I mean, yeah. You know, it took me years to get an Oscar.
Jamila, we'll start with you because the White House yesterday came out and made a pretty bold statement saying President Obama considers the attack on Dallas police a hate crime. You know, the killer specifically mentioned he wanted to kill white people, especially white police officers, according to law enforcement there. How do you feel about the president defining this as a hate crime?
You know, I have to say, I would not describe hate crime as the most comfortable word choice considering these circumstances. There's so much that we do not know about what took place, what motivated this person. We only have the one account of law enforcement. We haven't had the opportunity to really look into his history in a meaningful way. When we use a phrase like hate crime, we're typically referring to crimes against people of color, people of various religious groups, LGBT people, people who have been historically attacked, abused, or disenfranchised on the basis of their identity. To now extend that to the majority group and a group of people that has a history with African Americans that has been abusive, and we can apply that to either police officers or to Caucasians, I think gets into very tricky territory. So I'd be curious to know if he was referring to this as a hate crime because he singled them out by race or attempted to single them out by race or because they were police officers.
Steve, do you agree with that? The fact that this man was targeting white people, according to what he told police, does that fit the definition of a hate crime?
It absolutely fits the definition of the hate crime. You can't just say that only certain groups are allowed to be hated. Only certain groups can have crimes designated as hate crimes against them. That's racism. What you're doing here is saying that the actual truth of the matter is that hate crimes are defined as a crime against a specific race, doesn't list them, gender preference group, or membership in an organization. That's how it's defined. You can't just say if you're white, nobody can commit a hate crime against you. And this guy said, I'm doing it because you're white and I'm doing it because you're cops.
Before we dive into a set of facts and statistics that may boggle your mind, it's my duty to read you your Milo-approved Miranda rights. You have the right to controversial opinions and speech. You have the right to confront and to disagree with, to rebut and to question opinions that don't match your own. You have the right to do all of that without being told that you are violating a safe space. You have the right to reject the brainwashing forced upon you by professors that make Obama look like the aforesaid Che Guevara. And most importantly, you have the right to worship your dangerous faggot. Now, I'm not a real policeman, but... No, I know. I have had some policemen in me. Sorry, I'll stop. It's cheap. You should stop laughing. It just encourages me. That's not even in here. I'm just... But I do recognize that blue lives matter. That's right, yeah. Blue lives matter. Black Lives Matter doesn't really care about black lives. It's, as we'll discuss shortly, more of a movement for attention, money, and, like most activism, more money. To achieve these goals, they focus their energies on cases of black men killed by the police. Well, the work of criminologist Dr. Richard Johnson of the University of Toledo explains just how futile this is. And some of this stuff is tough to listen to. Some of this stuff is not pleasant. It's not the kind of thing that you want to discuss over cocktails. But it's important to understand the problem if you're going to fix it, which Black Lives Matter definitely can't. Based on 2012 numbers, it would take 40 years worth of blacks killed by police to equal the total number of blacks murdered by other blacks in a single year. Right. Less than 400 people a year are killed by cops. 61% of them are white men. 32% are black males. Black men are not killed out of proportion when you consider they're much more likely to interact with police. People are killed by police about as often as they're struck by lightning, but I don't see many protests about storms. Black males are 58% of those killed legally by private citizens in self-defense. And you think, aha, we've got you on something. Except 75% of them were killed by other blacks. FBI statistics on murder lay bare the real threat to black lives in America, and that is other blacks. Black men are about 6.5% of the US population, but they commit 52% of all murders. That has dipped to about 40% in recent years. Black men overwhelmingly murder other black people, and white people overwhelmingly murder other white people. So just like abuse and harassment on the internet, this isn't really a racial issue, like that isn't really a gendered issue. Looking at overall violent crime, blacks are 27% more likely to attack whites than vice versa, and 8 times more likely to attack Hispanics. This is the shocking number I hope you take away from my visit. 90% of blacks that die of murder die at the hands of other black people, and that's from the FBI homicide report, 90%. We're not here to talk about why this happens, why 74% of black children are raised without fathers, per Health and Human Services, and why the government seems intent on continuing a cycle of destruction within the black community. My message is simple. Black lives don't matter to Black Lives Matter.